Okay. Wait a minute. I'm seeing you. Did this just flip the camera?
No.
Oh, there's some sort of delay. Anyway, okay. There's not supposed to be a delay, but we'll see what happens. Hello, folks. Hopefully, technologically, we're working properly. We had a little bit of trouble trying to get landscape, so hopefully you're not having to look at your screen like this to see us. Anyway, thank you, folks, for joining us today. We're here at the First Presbyterian Church of Ridgefield Park. Now, I am here with the Metamorphic Winds Saxophone Quartet. These are all multi-talented woodwind doublers. They play a bunch of different instruments. They all play on Broadway, when there is a Broadway. But you don't want to hear me talk, you want to hear them play. Take it away, Metamorphic Winds. On the baritone sax. Now, this particular combo, this configuration of Metamorphic Winds, played together about 1 year ago on the, let me get this right, the Broadway Chamber Players International Women's Day Concert. That's quite a mouthful. My name is Jon Koons, and I will be singing a bunch of these songs, starting with this one. Embraceable You is by George and Ira Gershwin. It was originally written for an unpublished operetta named East is West, but then it was resurrected in 1930 for a Broadway musical after my own heart named Girl Crazy.
Thank you.
Now, the man who wrote this next song, and I want to get this right, the man who wrote this next song once said, "Humor heightens our sense of survival and helps to preserve our sanity, especially sage words these days." Since then, it's been a tradition for many singers to add their own verse or two of lyrics, which I've done as well. This number was arranged for the Metamorphic Winds by Mickey Ryan. Now, If You Knew Susie was originally written for Al Jolson by Buddy DeSilva and Joseph Meyer. It became hugely successful when Eddie Cantor recorded it in 1925. Years later, Jolson told Cantor, "If I knew it was that good, you dog, I'd never have given it to you." If you knew Susie like I know Susie, oh, 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 what a girl. There's none so classy as this fair lassie at all. Oh, holy Moses, what a chassis. We went riding, she didn't walk. Back from Yonkers, I'm the one who had to walk. If you knew Susie like I know Susie, oh, what a girl. If you knew Susie like I know Susie, Susie. We all love Susie. By the way, we want to thank you again for joining us. This is great that you're here with us. It's a little odd not having an audience right here in front of us, but we know there are hundreds of thousands of you watching us out there on our channel, Goat Films. Now, please, if you're watching us on Goat Films, do us a favor. Hit the like, hit the subscribe, so that we can keep bringing these great things to you. All right, As Time Goes By is by Herman Hupfeld and was made famous in the classic movie Casablanca. You know, play it again, Sam. Do you know that nobody actually ever says that in the movie? That's the title of a Woody Allen movie, and since then everyone thinks they say play it again, Sam. Nobody actually says that. So I'm gonna give you the quote exactly as it was said by the great Humphrey Bogart. Here it is. Play it, metamorphic winds. Play it again for old time's sake. Popular with his spirited rendition. Now, as a little personal note, I just wanted to mention that my son, Merlin Ryan, in school was assigned to pick a musician, a singer group that he was particularly fond of, and then do a podcast about it. This was the class assignment. So while the other kids in the class were picking, you know, Lady Gaga and Pitbull and whoever all those people are, my son chose Louis Armstrong. So I would like to now tell you something the way Louis used to tell about why he sang this particular song.
He said, I found a letter. I found a letter, and I read it through, and it made me think, I think I'd like to sing a song about that. Let me read this letter to you right now. Okay? Yeah.
It is Jobim. I should have said Jobim. Okay. Antonio Carlos Jobim. And it was arranged by Chris McDonald. Jobim is well known for bringing the bossa nova to the world. But this piece is a lovely waltz that was dedicated and named after his daughter, Luisa.
Thank you.
Louisa is, right? No. My wife and I actually wrote a song for my son. It's called In Search of Ryan. Maybe we'll play that one of these days. We'll do an arrangement for the group. That would be a lot of fun. Our Love Is Here to Stay is by, of course, George and Ira. It's from the movie The Goldwyn Follies. Now, on a personal note, this was the song at our wedding. Now, I don't know if you know, but this is my wife, Mickey. So this was the song, our song, at our wedding, and I am thrilled not only to sing it with, but for my lovely wife.
Thank you.
All right. Fortunately, it's not too windy here right now. Okay. This next number was written by Harold Arlen and was arranged by Mickey for Metamorphic Winds. This song was originally called If You Believed in Me and was written for an unsuccessful Broadway play called The Great Magoo, set in Coney Island. But you all know it from the movie Paper Moon.